while we're still on the subject of Sable, who I could talk about for hours, you know, hosting NFL The Grind on Epics with you and Paul Camerata and the rest of the NFL Films crew behind it. When I was like, hey, let's do the end of show essay on X, Y, and Z. And then you would dive into Steve Sable's note card system where he would just pull stuff from periodicals or articles or just write down quotes that George Patton once said or what Orwell once said and put it on a card that was labeled like Tom Brady or labeled Tom Landry. And he would file it away and would pull it out so he could use it for himself. And you gave us to me to help me write. Oh, God, I'm getting goosebumps just talking about it, Ken. And on occasion, Chris Brockman, my producer here, can attest, we would put that stuff on the air here. I mean, we would.
Absolutely.
And so that card system still exists, correct, as well?
It does. I mean, his office still exists very much like it did the day he passed. And, I mean, it was the internet before the internet.
Yeah.
He would read dozens of newspapers on a daily basis. He, of course, was a voracious reader of novels and everything else, periodicals. And he would write down quotes that would be in an article about Napoleon. It would be a quote about Napoleon, but he would see that it applied
to Doug Flutie.
To Vince Lombardi or Doug Flutie.
Because
right. Doug Flutie is a good example.
Right.
And he would put it in a file under Doug Flutie's name. And still to this day, if we're writing about Doug Flutie or we're writing about coaches in general, he has files for both big picture general, like failure or close games or overtime,
amazing,
subjects like that, but also individuals that now we may forget because they played in the 60s or 70s or 80s when he was at his height. So in a way, he's still with us and really giving us his opinions on a lot of subjects.
All right, before I let you go, Ken, I know I'm going to put you on the spot here by asking this question, but, you know, you've been there before. So what? Steve Sable once told me, that I think it might have been 15-some-odd years ago, that there is, in fact, an archive tape of outtakes of John Facenda cursing a blue streak, and that exists. And I asked him, can I hear it? He said, no. Will anybody ever hear it? He said, forget that. Never. Have you ever heard it? Have you ever heard that outtake?
I have not, but
yes,
I'm going to go looking for it now.
It's somewhere. You know, we've already established he's kept everything. He said that Facenda, whenever he would, like, you know, it wasn't one take, John. You know, we're very rare anybody does it in one take. He said that Facenda, whenever he would maybe get caught up on a line that he couldn't nail to his liking, he would just, like, curse up a blue streak, and those outtakes exist. Man, would I love to hear those. Those would be phenomenal.
Man, that sounds like a new 30 for 30.
The search of the lost Facenda blue streak tapes. I would love to help with that production. Right, you know.
Yes, I know you would.
Unbelievable. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.